Normally, guys, when we're doing Drytron combos, we try to show it in real life and profiles in real life, but just for this specific scenario, let's show it off online. What's going on, guys? Pegasus and the Wise Guys. Appreciate you guys for tuning in. So many people have been asking about the double scythe combo that has existed for a while. A lot of people were hiding it for Nats. I don't think anybody actually ended up playing it for Nats, but this is just the optional combo that you could have definitely played if you rocked out with this version of the combo and this version of the deck, but hey, that's up to you. Alpha Zeta has many, many, many different lines. This is just one of them that is relatively strong and unblockable. So let's get into it. Alpha Pitch Zeta, add Ben 10. Pitch Ben 10, Special Summon Zeta. The normal standard that you always have with this combo, thus ending with the Ritual Spell and the Diviner, beginning with the Ritual Spell and Diviner to start off with. Then overlaying for Fafnir. Fafnir is obviously going to dump Gamma. The way so many of these combos end up, and this essentially plays around Nibiru a little bit because you're at least going to get an additional Fairy or an additional Ritual Monster of some sort to be able to add to your hand, but just in case, you're going to be able to just jump straight into an Ultimaya Tazulkin. Now, obviously, Tazulkin has been bumped a little bit by a powerful card like Baron, and that's just basically because if the Diviner gets stopped in any way, it's not over level 5, therefore Tazulkin is not viable at that point. But then again, neither would a Baron if we're just working it out like that. But regardless of whichever it is, it 100% is a very, very strong, potent combo to start off with. Continuing on with this combo, though, essentially getting the Ophiel and then summoning out the full that you added off of the Ophiel, then adding back the Ben 10, pitching the Ben 10, special summoning out the second Ophiel. This is exactly why you have to play two Ophiels, by the way, guys. And then essentially ending with Artifact Lancia as well as Baythor, then using the Tazulkin and the Fafnir that's on your side of the board to make an actual Entis, which is where the combo gets a little bit silly and a lot of people could not figure it out. Essentially, having an Entis as material under a Tornado Dragon means you essentially get two pops and two different chain links. And then being able to trigger that immediately as soon as your opponent's turn starts allows you to have a second Scythe. Then the Tornado Dragon pops the first Scythe, then you get to trigger that Scythe, and then clearly, if they have not stopped the Entis in any kind of way, then the Entis will also get to target the second Scythe because, well, you chained a dagger and put a second one on the board. The reason why this is so busted is because it comes out in layers, therefore a droplet will not stop this, and a Called by Grave or a Ndidi Crow or anything else that could possibly interrupt this won't stop it either because you ended on Lancia. It was shown in the video the other day, but just for recapping and understanding purposes, this is pretty much the build that a lot of folks were on that wanted to play this. It's missing Droplin in the main deck, obviously, because you're playing a little bit more of a brick package and playing cards like Valk, which is another brick in and of itself. But if you do actually end up needing the Valk, it actually can turn insane or end up ending a game very, very quickly. Again, you guys, you could obviously play Baron and figure out the combo in a different type of way, obviously with Baron having its own way to bring Scythe back and being able to possibly be on the field as well as the Tornado Dragon, that could add yet another layer. So that's just something to consider and something to kind of mess around with. And then as far as Drytron theory, you guys don't need to hear any more of that. It just is what it is at this point, and it's really about what variant works the best for you, what specific text you can add. As you guys saw, the Cerevis and the Fucho stuff inside of the side deck that we had mentioned before as well, and so many people have played at Nats as well. But as far as the rest of the list, guys, it really is up to you how you want to play any of these variants. You have to always try to work for the best optimization possible. And clearly with stuff like Fucho as well as Featherstorm being a real thing now, that may just be a whole nother wave by itself that you will probably have to be able to stop a deck like Splite and Tyralements, because they are coming extremely soon. Trust me on that. As far as, again, the breakdown, I feel like this probably isn't the best version, but the Megaliths are. So this, while it also is very, very powerful and unblockable, again, it might not be the absolute best build, but it's definitely something that you have to consider, because the Megaliths are probably the best version. This just may not be the best version of Megaliths. All rectangles are square and square. You get what I'm saying. I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Make sure you stay tuned because this Marin Says content is up next. And man, is this deck gas. Appreciate you guys for tuning in. Pegasus signing out. Arrivederci.